Hi all, my name is Malika and today we are having Manizha. Thank you for coming, Manizha. How are you?
Thank you. Great. That's great to have you here.
Please tell us, how is it working at Platinum? And could you please explain the role of B2B manager at Platinum?
Sure. I really love working at Platinum because this company gives me a lot of inspiration on a daily basis. I'm doing all of the tasks with a big decision, like the desire of doing all of this stuff is really coming from the inside. So this is pretty interesting to go deeper into the tasks and to see whether we can collaborate with those people or those companies. So this is pretty interesting, I would say.
Yeah, thank you. And could you please describe your current role and responsibilities in your current job?
Sure. I'm a BD manager at B2B department of Platinum Fund. So I really love this job because it gives me the opportunity of speaking to a lot of different people every day. And that's how I get connected to interesting people in the sector, like in Web3 and also in general in the world. So this is really opportunable.
Totally, totally agree. And what is your typical daily routine at work and how do you prioritize tasks and manage your time? I know that you are a very hardworking person and you do a lot.
Thank you. So yeah, actually we have a lot of different tasks during the day and they come with different priorities. So for example, I can have like two or three different difficult tasks per day. And most of them would be really interesting because I communicate with people a lot and also I speak a lot of different words with people who came from different countries. And if you speak about the tasks themselves, then they can be pretty different depending on what priorities and strategies we have at the fund at the moment. So it really depends on the stripe, I would say, that we have and on the quarter that we're working in. And most of the funds, they have really different strategies throughout the time. And that can be pretty depending on the situation.
Yeah, and I know that last year you were studying and working at the same time. And how did you manage that?
Yeah, that was a pretty hard year actually for me, but it wasn't the first year for me working and studying at the same time, so it was like the second or third, to be honest. So it was pretty adaptable, so I was trying to do my best here and there, like studying and also working. Sometimes my study was suffering because of my work, and I still tried to do my best, and that all happened to be like the final result. So I'm really hopefully thinking that that's not gonna like go again like this, but still that was a great part of my life, and I'm happy to be here now.
Thank you. And what strategies do you usually use to stay organized and meet deadlines at work?
So thank you for the question. That's really interesting. And I'm the person who looks for the systematization in everything. So I prefer to write down all the tasks that I have for the day, like in the notes that I have on my phone or in the notebook and laptop that I work with. And I just write all the things down. That helps me not to have it all in my brain and not to get rid of some thoughts that that just can ruin my day. And that pretty helps a lot. So I do use Notion as well. I use a lot of different note-taking apps. I do use habit trackers, and I try to do my best no matter what is going on throughout the day.
Okay, you're a super disciplined person. Yeah, that's
thank you.
That's
thank
the secret. You. Yeah, and you speak perfect English. How did you learn it? Because your native language is Tajik and Russian. You're bilingual, right?
Yeah, actually, that's not my first language. But I still do speak a lot in English throughout the day, especially at my work, when we meet a lot of different people and just to ask them about the startups, about the companies they work at. And except of this, I was doing a lot of study by my own. Like it started 6 years ago. Then I was going through the study at the school and also university, then also the working years. All of this stuff helped me to gain more experience and to get better understanding of how to use these word connections and also phrases that we can use every day. So this really helped a lot. And I was watching a lot of different series in English with no translation, with subtitles, just to get a better understanding how they use this or that word and phrases in general. So that really helped a lot. And also I'm still daily listening to music, listening to the American songwriters. So this also can help you, this helped me. And I guess that can help a lot of people as well.
Totally, thank you. And what did you study at the university?
So I studied the social intercultural communication. We were talking about, most of the time we were studying diplomacy, and also we were studying relationships between countries. So that's how I learned English better and also diplomacy itself. So during the study, I was also learning a lot of hobbies that I had, for example, playing guitar, singing songs and etc. And I was trying to do this all with my work. So yeah, that was pretty hard years, but actually I gained a lot of experience, like a baggage of experience. So I'm pretty thankful for this.
Thank you. And how do you spend your free time?
In my free time, I usually prefer to go for walks a lot, because that helps me to get rid of all of the negative thoughts that I can have throughout the day, and also to refresh my mind for the next day. I usually watch some kind of series in English still, just to improve my language, because that really helps, as I mentioned before. And also I do love crocheting. I do love making some kind of art stuff. I create some accessories, some hats and etc. So this really helps me to reload after the working day.
Nice. And also I know that you spend a lot of time with your animals. You have
of course. Yeah. Thank you. So yeah, they are pretty small. Like I have two little turtles. I really love spending time with them, because they are pretty calm. How to say, they are calm by their nature. So that helps me to get a better understanding of why shouldn't I be aggressive, or why should I be calm. So yeah, that's priceless moments that I spend with the pets. All of the moments that we spend with our pets or babies, they are just pretty priceless for all of us.
Thank you. And yeah, I know that you work a lot. And could you please share what steps do you take to maintain a positive work ethic and keep yourself motivated and engaged?
So I really love learning, and that helps me a lot, because throughout the day I get a better understanding of many different things. For example, we can be working with different companies, with different startups and etc. And they all have different aspects. They all have different backgrounds. Like the founders of the project have different backgrounds and experience. And if to speak about the work ethic, then I definitely, I'm really thankful for the opportunity to learn every day. So I keep learning no matter what is going on, even if I don't have any calls with people or even if I don't have any tasks. So that happens really rarely, of course, but still I try to learn something throughout the day so that I can know that I just didn't spare my time with doing nothing. So yeah, that helps me a lot.
Thanks. And could you please name some, I don't know, top three pros and contras about your work?
I would say that I would start with cons. So one of them is being stressful position. This work is not for everyone. Absolutely, not everyone can do this. But if you will gain some kind of experience throughout the time, then I'm sure that you will be doing your best. And if to speak about other cons, then I would say stressful moments. Also, sometimes there should be some kind of dismotivation because I have this overloaded mind with all of this information that I learned throughout the day, and then I just sit and think, like, do I need this? Do I need this information to be loaded into my head, like, or not? And if to speak about the pros that this position has, then I would definitely recommend you this position because you can get more opportunities to meet new people every day, just to get expanded in terms of your connections. Your networking stuff will be really expanding every day. For example, before coming to this company, I didn't know, like, what is the Web3, why this exists, what kind of things does it include or it doesn't. So yeah, that helped me a lot to learn new stuff, and that's why I'm really thankful to be here now.
Thank you. Yeah. And what are you planning to do next? I mean, you've finished the university and now you're working and you like it, but, like, what next?
So I'm trying to keep developing throughout the days of my work. As I mentioned, I learn a lot. I try to have my hand on pulse just to know what updates are going on in the world. I would rather travel somewhere in the future, maybe somewhere to Europe or to the States, just to see what kind of corporate culture they have, work ethics that they have, and then to implement it in our company, because our CTO and our colleagues, they usually like hearing new ideas, some sort of new things that you can bring to the company. So everything should work well, as I imagine. So yeah, that's what kind of plans I have at the moment. And also, I would say that I will definitely keep developing in terms of my position, because I know there are a lot of different things that I haven't even reached out yet. So I still have to continue my study and know better about what kind of things I don't know about. So yeah, I'm still trying to do this.
And what excites you most about working at Platinum?
So I would say that, of course, meeting new people. Like, we have a big collective of our teammates, and this is pretty exciting because most of us are pretty different with all of the lifestyle that we have, with all of the desires and decisions that we make every day. But still, something really big connects us. Like, we are working here together. It means that something in common is there. So this is really exciting thing for me, because every day throughout talking to our teammates, I can see that we definitely have something in common, and we can be doing big things together. And we should keep this work and life balance, just to go through this. And I know that in future we will be definitely doing big things together.
Thanks. And could you please share your opinion about working remotely? And have you ever seen your colleagues in person?
Of course. If to speak about Platinum, then no, I actually haven't met anyone yet, but I would rather to see them offline as well, because talking to someone via laptop and seeing them in real life is something different. So I would rather to get this experience, actually. That would be really exciting. And if to speak about the remote job that I have, actually, this is sometimes it's stressful when the light is off and I don't have the charger near me. So and sometimes I don't even have time to cook something for myself, so I just go somewhere to eat, maybe to a cafe or somewhere else. And sometimes it's pretty stressful to be working from one place. For example, I usually work from home, but I prefer to go somewhere, like to cafes, to parks, to work. So this really helps to refresh your mind and also not to get stuck in the daily routine that you have.
Thank you so much, Manizha. It was a pleasure chatting to you today. And see you at the next meeting we have in an hour.
Thank you. That's amazing. Thank you. Have a nice part of your day then. Let's keep in touch.
You too. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Bye.